Now I will tell you about myself. I am Pawan Kumar. I teach physics in Government College, Himachal Pradesh. Presently, I am posted at Center of Excellence, Government Degree College, Singrauli, which is at Shimla. I have teaching experience of 22 years. Out of these 22 years, for 11 years, I have taught physics at plus 1 and plus 2 level in different schools of Himachal Pradesh. And for the remaining 11 years, I am teaching physics at undergraduate level at different colleges in Himachal Pradesh. I have completed my BSc from MLSM College Sundarnagar, which is in Himachal Pradesh. I did my MSc from HP University, and then I completed my MPhil. My MPhil was in nuclear physics, and my dissertation was on double beta decay problem. After this, I did one diploma, which is known as postgraduate diploma in higher education, in order to understand higher education, the concept of higher education. And then I enrolled myself for PhD, in which I worked on nanomaterials. My nanomaterial was cobalt ferrite, basic material. And then I doped it with lanthanum and gadolinium. Lanthanum 3 plus ions are non-magnetic. Gadolinium 3 plus ions are highly magnetic. So we studied the effect of non-magnetic and highly magnetic ions on cobalt ferrite and compared their properties. And next, I have done one refresher course in theoretical physics and two refresher courses in experimental physics. I have also done one orientation course in which I have learned the intricacies of teaching. Among my strengths, which I consider my strength, is that I stay in my college for more than 7 hours. And out of these 7 hours, 90% of time I stay in my department, where students can meet me and I am available to them. I am a member of some academic bodies like Indian Association of Physics Teacher at national level and Himachal Science Congress Association at state level. In addition to teaching physics, I have many hobbies. Out of these hobbies, one which relates to my subject and to my strengths is astronomy. I own a telescope, 130 mm reflector, which I use to conduct sky watching session with my students, with general public, sometimes to teachers of school, colleges, etc. I run an informal club through which I do all these activities. In this summer, I have conducted 3 sky watching sessions through this telescope. And this is a very good activity which make me help people understand science and astronomy and also remove some of the myths in their minds. And this is one of the photographs which you can see with my telescope. And that's all about this. Thank you. So, dear students, I welcome you in this class, and this will be your first lecture in this course, Mechanics. And today's lecture will be just recapitulation of what you have studied up to plus 2 level. And our lecture will start with the definition of physical quantities. What are physical quantities? Physical quantities are those quantities which can be measured. If a quantity can be measured, it is physical quantity. Let us talk about the example. For example, a person is very good, but that goodness cannot be measured. How much good that person is? We have no units of goodness. We simply say that person is very good, that person is very nice, that person is very beautiful. So goodness, beauty, these are not physical quantity. So what is a physical quantity which can be measured? It's mass of something, mass of this duster. Let me say, if its mass is 60 gram, then this is a physical quantity because it can be measured. So a physical quantity is that quantity which can be measured. Next is, how many types of physical quantity we have? We have vectors and scalars. Yes, scalars are simpler type of physical quantities. Why simpler? Because these scalars have only magnitude. Only magnitude. So as I earlier told you that this duster is 60 gram, so no direction, no anything. So 60 gram is enough to describe mass of this duster. So mass is a physical quantity and it is scale. Because when I say 50 gram, I express its magnitude. Next is vectors. Vectors are both physical quantities which have magnitude as well as direction. If we say only magnitude of a vector quantity, that will not be enough to describe that physical quantity. We need to give its direction too. For example, velocity of a body. So vectors have magnitude as well as direction. So here direction example can be velocity of a body, which can be described if I say 3 meter per second due north, due east. I have to say the magnitude as well as its direction. And here,
describing this mass of this duster, I said
60 gram. 60 gram, just mass, no direction. We don't say mass of this duster is 60 gram due north, due east. That is not meaning. So we have physical quantity, we define
physical quantity which can be measured.
We have some quantity which are not physical quantity. For example, goodness. For example, beauty. These are not physical quantity because these cannot be measured. We have physical quantities, velocity, mass, length, time, density, and so on. But we have to say something more about these vectors. Something more. For example, current. Current is a physical quantity which has magnitude. We also say that current is flowing in this wire like this. But current is still not a physical vector quantity. Why? Because it can be added algebraically. Vectors should have magnitude, direction, and should follow vector laws of addition. That is another thing. That is another description which we add to the definition of vectors. These scalars follow the scalar laws or algebraic laws of addition. For example, here I say that I am having a duster 60 gram plus I have chalk box 40 gram, then total mass of duster plus this chalk duster box, a chalk box is 100 gram. So here we have added these quantities algebraically. And if I come to the vectors, then if I have velocity of a body, let me say east, 3 meter per second. Let me say 2 meter per second due north. If I want to add these two vectors, then I cannot say 2 meter plus 3 meter, 2 meter per second plus 3 meter per second equal to 5 meter per second. That will be wrong. We have to add these two velocities as per the vector laws of addition. And what are vector laws of addition? Vector laws of addition. We have two laws. One is triangle law of vector addition, parallelogram law of vector addition. So we can use these two laws whenever we have to add two vectors. See, I am having this vector, let me call it vector A, vector B. Then if I have to add these two vectors as per triangle of vector addition, what will I do? First of all, I will draw these two vectors in this way. I will translocate it like this, parallelly moving this. This is vector A, this is vector B, and closing side of the triangle drawn in opposite direction will give the resultant of, yes, resultant of addition of these two vectors A and B. And I will write down R is equal to A plus B. I can also write down the magnitude of this resultant. How? You have already studied it. R will be, magnitude of R will be written like this. You know this. This will be equal to A square plus B square plus 2AB cos of theta under root. So this will give us the resultant of two vectors. Here you can see I have written A and B. A and B are simply magnitude. And theta is this angle. Angle between A and B. Yes, two vectors which we are adding. Next topic is resolution of vectors. Resolution of vectors. As we have added two vectors, we can also resolve a vector into its components. For example, we have a vector R, and I am asked to resolve this vector R into two directions given by these two vectors. Then what will I do? I will complete a triangle in this way. This is vector R. I will draw one vector extending in the direction of this vector A like this, and I will draw another vector in the direction of vector B. So it will be something like this, parallel to this. So this is vector R, and what will be this side of the triangle? This will be some scalar multiple of this A. Let me say MA. And this will be some scalar multiple of this B. So let me write down NB. So I can say that vector R is resolved into its components in two directions, A and B, given by this. So this is the resolution of vector in the direction of two given vectors. Although there are infinite ways of resolving a vector into its component, but if we are given the direction in which we have to resolve a vector, then there is only one way. So we say the resolution of vector in given direction is unique. But this is not the most common way of resolving into its component. The most common way is this one. But we say along the sides of a rectangle. That is, what is this called? Resolution of vector along x and y. So if we say, if we have this vector R and we have to resolve it into two components, one of which is along x direction and other is along y direction, then what I will do? I will draw a perpendicular from this side, and I will draw a perpendicular on y axis. And what will I do? If this angle is theta, this side is x, then what will be x? X will be R cos theta. But because this is a vector, so I will write down something like this, where I is the unit vector along x axis. Alright? Yes. And what about the component along y axis? Yes, that will be y will be equal to R sine theta j, where j is the unit vector along y. So that's all. Now I will tell you about my work. I always endeavor to find innovative ways to engage my students while teaching or in the department. One of our activity we have done in our department is that our computer lab, that is the computer lab of this department, is open from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. for all the students. All the computers have been made dual boot, that is they run on Windows operating system as well as Linux. This gives the students an opportunity to work on Linux also, and they get familiar with this operating system also. The third innovation which we have done in our department is that we have made our classroom a smart classroom by installing a projector in the classroom. And sometimes what happens, the classroom is busy with a class. We have acquired another KON, which is multimedia integrated computer audio video projector system, and we have also made that available to our students. And this is another innovation is that we have made available our students breadboard so that they can learn electronics and develop their hobby through the breadboards. This is another thing which we have done in our college. I being coordinator of spoken tutorials which are run in collaboration with IIT Bombay. What happens in this is that students are offered many courses under these spoken tutorials like Linux, LaTeX, C++, Avogadro, Scilab, etc. Student can opt for more than one course and they can do it at basic, intermediate and advanced level. So many students have got their training basic level through these courses and they have finally got their certificates. And another innovation which I always do in my classroom is that I conduct many quizzes. Whenever a topic is complete, I ask my student to prepare a quiz and conduct it. So it is their responsibility and they do it well. The winner team is offered an opportunity to get photographed with me, which they enjoy, and they vibe with each other to get this opportunity. And that photograph is posted on my blog, which is for physics teachers and students. Here you can see also me with my telescope, and our student is also busy making some observation in the sky with small telescope. And here you can see I have done one program under Prayas, which is a program for school teachers in motivating them to teach science and mathematics. And then this is one of the activities which we have done in our college this year. And here we have invited Professor Marwaha from Chandigarh. He gave many demonstrations, and students and teachers were all actively involved, and this ran for 4 to 5 hours, and this activity was a hit with all the students. And here again me with school teacher. And this is another activity which we are doing for last 2 years, that is we are training students for IIT JAM, that is the entrance examination which is conducted by IITs and which is valid for MSc admissions in IITs, ICER, NIT and even in Indian Institute of Science. So what we do, we take 10 to 15 days and we help students in problem solving methods. This year, even that is in 2017, we have already done in first week of July this activity, and students are very happy with this. Thank you. Now I will tell you about my achievements. This is my Junior Search Fellow Award, which is awarded after qualifying CSR NET exam. I was awarded with this fellowship way back in 1992. Next is my Best Oral Presentation Award. I made this presentation in a workshop seminar which was held at Sunni University. And here you can see my achievements in research. This is data which we have taken from ResearchGate portal. Here you can see that I have published 12 papers which have 406 reads and 94 citations. And here you can see the data which we have taken from Google Scholar portal. And here you can see that I have 93 citations in total, 87 after 2012. And my H-index is 3 and I-10 index is 2. And here you can see the list of my publications, which are back. Effect of lanthanum 3 plus doping on the electric, dielectric and magnetic properties of cobalt ferrite processed by co-precipitation technique. This paper was published in Journal of Alloys and Compound, having impact factor more than 2.5. And the next is effect of gadolinium 3 plus doping on magnetic, electric and dielectric properties of magnesium gadolinium ferrites processed by solid state reaction techniques. This was again published in General Alloys and Compound. And you can see this is having this paper is cited by 23 researchers, and the earlier paper was cited by 57. That first paper is my most cited paper. And the next, the third one is investigations of lanthanum doping on magnetic properties of nano cobalt ferrites. And the list goes on. Here you can see again some papers. Ferromagnetic ordering in lanthanum substituted nano cobalt ferrites at room temperature. This was cited by three researchers. And similarly, the list goes on. And this is the list of all my 12 research papers. And here I have made presentation in different conferences. I have done many presentation, many conferences, and the list goes on. Next, and yes, this is another presentation, and this list goes on. And this is one of the most notable presentation which I have done abroad in Cambridge University in ICU 2011 conference. And this is the list continues, more presentations, again more, and these are some of the invited talks and lectures. I have made many I have given many talks on varied subjects, some on physics, my research interests, some on Mars orbital mission, which you can see, some on guidance and counseling. Recently I have delivered two talks at SCRT Solon on guidance and counseling to college teachers, to student, school lecturers. And yes, this is the list. Yes, the list continues. I have also been member of some science programs. You can see in the, here I have listed two programs, recent program last year. And here some of the workshop and training which I have undergone. You can see I have done one refresher course, workshop training through Indian Academy of Science at Bangalore. And this is one of my students who is doing his summer research fellowship program at Gorakhpur University. And these are some of the achievements of our students in Spoken Tutorial, where they are learning computers. And you know, computers are third way of doing physics. After theoretical physics, experimental physics, we can do physics through computer, which is known as third way of doing physics. So Mukul Thakur has topped in Linux course, and here you can see Lalit Kumar topped in Scilab. Thank you.